Hello to all, my name is Manisha Singla from MECSC Thapar University Patiala, presenting here my dissertation topic on application of scattered context grammar for resolving dependency in Hindi language under the supervision of Dr. Ajay Kumar, Assistant Professor, Computer Science Department, Thapar University Patiala. To start with, what is scattered context grammar? Scattered context grammar is a grammar which is first introduced by S. Kripak and J. Hopcroft. In this grammar, each and every production is having n context reproductions which are to be applied in parallel to the current sentential form. It specifies both the natural language as well as the programming language. It is also having its generative power between context-free grammar and context-sensitive grammar. Because this grammar is having n context-free productions and these productions are to be applied in parallel to the current sentential form, it can describe some of the context-sensitive language as well, like a to the power n, b to the power n, and c to the power n, where n is greater than 1. The next slide presenting here the example that how scattered context grammar can describe some of the context-sensitive language as well. Like a scattered context production A, B, C to AA, BB, CC is having actually three context-free productions A to AA, B to BB, C to CC, and these productions are to be applied in parallel. If we add productions S to A, B, C and A, B, C to A, B, C, then scattered context grammar can also describe A to the power n, B to the power n and C to the power n, where n is greater than 1, which is actually a context sensitive language. Next is another part of my dissertation topic. What is Hindi dependency parsing? Hindi dependency parsing consists of analyzing and parsing dependencies between words in Hindi sentences. Hindi language consists of both serial and cross-serial dependencies, where serial dependency means the dependent lines do not intersect with each other in any sentence. And the cross-serial dependency means in a Hindi sentence the dependent lines intersect each other. Usually cross-serial dependencies are handled by context-sensitive grammar, but context-sensitive grammar leads to the generation of complex rule to handle such dependencies. There are various type of parsers which are designed to describe Hindi dependencies, like MALT parser, shallow parser, Talbot parser, MST parser and Hindi dependency parser. We have used Hindi dependency parser in our work. Next is another part of my dissertation, which is literature survey. Meduna connects a theoretically oriented discussion of scattered context grammar with the pragmatically oriented discussion of scattered context grammar in English linguistics. This work of Meduna inspired me to use the scattered context grammar in Hindi linguistics as well. For example, Meduna proposed that if there is a sentence like he works well in computer science, if in this sentence he changes to I, the sentence would be illegal to write as I works well in computer science, because with he we may use s or es with the verb, but with I we cannot use s or es with the verb. So the sentence would be correctly written as I work well in computer science. And the scattered context production for this change is he, works to I, work. So whenever a sentence comprises of he and works, this automatically would change into I and work in the sentence. Next is another work done by various researchers in this field, like Kosaraju, Ambati, Gade, Butt and many others who have worked in Hindi dependency parser or scattered context grammar. Next is the objective and problem statement. Context-free grammar can be used to handle dependencies between the Hindi words, but context-free grammar is used only where the adjacent words of the sentences are dependent, but it cannot handle those dependencies where infinite number of words can come between the dependent words. Scattered context grammar can be used to handle those dependencies. Context-sensitive grammar can be used for handling cross-serial dependencies, but these dependencies may generate complex rules. Based on the literature survey, following objectives are outlined: to analyze varieties of tools and techniques available to handle dependencies. Next, to describe and to design transducers for converting singular to plural for nouns, verbs and adjectives when they are converted to their plural forms. to generate dependency tree or graph for representing interchunk as well as intrachunk dependencies in Hindi languages. Next is the work done by me, scattered context grammar in Hindi linguistics. There are various dependencies among the Hindi words which are described and generated using Hindi dependency parser. Hindi dependency parser lists all the dependencies with the help of Hindi dependency dataset, which consists of columns like word, word ID, parent ID, post tagging, and dependency labels. Where word comprises of the Hindi words itself, word ID comprises of the index of the Hindi word, parent ID comprises of the ID on which word depends upon, post tagging comprises of part of speech tagging which tells whether the word is noun, verb, adjective, etc. Next is the dependency label, consists of K1, K2, etc. representing karta, karam, karan, etc. These dependencies are represented with the help of dependency graph generated using NetworkX. After getting all the dependencies, it is required to convert the singular form of the dependent words to their plural forms, and after that scattered context rules are applied over those dependent sets. Next is the Hindi dependency parser. Suppose a user enters a Hindi sentence like Ram ne Shyam ko Sita ke saath bhi hamesha saath rehne ki salah di, then this input file is fed to the Hindi dependency parser, which indeed generates Hindi dependency datasets as shown in figure 2. After getting these Hindi dependency dataset, it is used to generate the dependency graph using NetworkX tool, which is as shown here in the figure. Dependencies are represented using indexes, where these indexes represent the corresponding words. This is similar to the graph as shown with the help of indexes. Next is the algorithm. There is an algorithm which is used to generate the dependency graph from those dependencies dataset. This is the algorithm which is used in generating the dependency graph. After getting all the dependencies, it is required to convert the singular form to their plural forms. For these conversion, we are using transducers for nouns, verbs as well as adjectives. For example, if we are at a state Q0 and we are having a masculine noun ends with A, for example, ladka here ends with A. If this ladka is needed to convert into its plural form, then we need to drop A from its end and add A. So it is converted to ladke. Similarly, in verbs also, suppose we have a regular verb, suppose khata, then we have to remove A and add E, that means khate, and similarly many other forms also. Next is the transducers for adjectives. Like we have chota, if we use chota, then masculine noun drops A, that means chota, and adds E, that means chote. So these are the rules which are used to convert singular forms to their plural forms. Scattered context rules for nouns. For example, masculine noun. Ladka har roz apne doston ke saath football khelta hai. If this converted to its plural form, then it would be ladke har roz apne doston ke saath football khelte hain. Similarly, if we have feminine noun, ladki kam umr mein bhi bahut sundar nritya karti hai, then the above sentence is converted into ladkiyan kam umr mein bhi bahut sundar nritya karti hain. And the rules for scattered context grammar is singular noun as subject, comma singular verb of predicates. Singular noun, that means ladka, comma singular verb khelta, is converted into plural noun as subject, ladki, plural verb of predicates khelte. Similarly, scattered context rule for verbs. Verb must change according to gender, noun, person, tenses and mood. We are explaining here with the help of example of nouns. Ram ko abhi gulab jamun khana hai. Here gulab jamun is masculine noun, and if this masculine noun is converted into into feminine noun like kulfi, then khana is also converted into khani. So the scattered context grammar is produces a rule which is masculine noun in subject singular, comma verb ending with a, to feminine noun in subject singular, verb ending with I. Next is the scattered context rules for adjectives. There are two types of adjectives, inflecting adjectives and non-inflecting adjectives, and the rules are as described below. हिंदी लैंग्वेज ऑल्सो कंसिस्ट ऑफ क्रॉस एरियल डिपेंडेंसीज लाइक पुस्तक मेज पर बिखरी पड़ी थी. इफ वी लुक एट दिस सेंटेंस केयरफुली वी हैव एक्चुअली टू सेंटेंस पुस्तक बिखरी थी मेज पर पड़ी थी. इफ दीज टू सेंटेंसेज आर इंडिविजुअली कन्वर्टेड इन टू देयर प्लूरल फॉर्म देन दीज वुड बी पुस्तकें बिखरी थी मेज पर पड़ी थी एंड देन अगेन वी नीड टू एडजॉइन दीज सेंटेंसेज टू गेट द रिजल्ट. सो द प्लूरल फॉर्म ऑफ द सेंटेंस इज पुस्तकें मेज पर बिखरी पड़ी थी. हिंदी सेंटेंस ऑल्सो मेक्स यूज ऑफ क्लोजेज विद नीदर और नॉर. For this, we need to use transformational context grammar, which is a step higher version of scattered context grammar. Suppose we have a sentence like "मैं न हिंदी सीखूँगा न English." This can be converted into "मैं या हिंदी सीखूँगा या English." So the scattered context production for such sentences "न कॉमा न" to "या या." Next is the contribution to the research. Scattered context grammar applied to Hindi linguistic result in easily demonstrating Hindi dependencies. We have context-sensitive rules which are generalized for nouns, verbs as well as adjectives. Dependencies can be recognized using dependency graph built using network X. Next is the conclusion of the above work. With the help of scattered context grammar in Hindi dependencies, complex set of rules of context-sensitive grammar can be avoided. As these scattered context grammar forms the production rules for the singular sentence to plural sentence, user also becomes aware of the grammatical error which may appear while translating sentence from singular to plural. Scattered context grammar is capable of handling both interjunct as well as intrajunct dependencies. Scattered context rules are developed for nouns, adjectives and verbs, are generalized rules and are not restricted to some specific Hindi sentence. Next is the publication. Here we have written a research paper named as Application of Scattered Context Grammar for Resolving Dependency in Hindi Language under ICICIC conference under IEEE, which is having the status of accepted. And we may check this paper after 1st of August after its publication. Next is the references. For more references, we can refer to the previous. We can refer to the paper as shown in the previous slide. And these are the references which are concerned with this work. Thank you.